Hi, this is Pritha, and apart from editing Kindle, I also happen to write poetry. And this space where the clarity of journalistic inquiry meets this wondrous arc of poetic inquiry is where I feel my journalism comes a full circle. You know, Pablo Neruda has been perhaps one of the greatest influences of my life. He has secured me, embraced me in the warmest possible way, and has also then delivered me into the great blue open skies. And Neruda, in his memoirs, while writing about poetry, says somewhere that poetry has lost its ties with the reader. It has to get him back. It has to walk in the darkness, encounter the heart of man, the eyes of woman, the stranger in the streets, those who, that in twilight or in the middle of the starry night, feel the need for at least one line of poetry. That journey to the unexpected is worth all the distance covered, everything read, everything learned. This, perhaps, is an attempt to do just that. And today, I'll be talking about one of my personal favorite books of Neruda, which is this lovely collection of poems called The Book of Questions. And this particular collection, Neruda had finished right before his death in September 1973. And you know why these poems are unique? Because they're very brief, concise poems that are entirely composed of questions. So in a way, these poems take shape in the realm of paradox. And what Neruda has done here is forge these deeply organic ties with the material world around him. You know, by using some really radical imagery, he has created this new world which is in a continual flux of ideas, which is in a continual flux of knowing and unknowing, learning and unlearning. And I'd just like to read one or two poems from this collection so you get to know how beautifully unique and lovely these poems are. Look, here is one in which he asks, "Tell me, is the rose naked or is that her only dress? Why do trees conceal the splendor of their own roots? Who hears the regrets of the thieving automobile? Is there anything in the world sadder than a rain standing in the rain? If I have died and don't know it, of whom do I ask the time? In France, where does spring get so many leaves? Where can a blind man live who is pursued by bees? If the color yellow runs out, with what will we make bread?" So these are some of these lovely poems which actually inspired me to write my own ode to Neruda. And I've titled my collection as Ode to the Book of Questions. And you know, these are poems which perhaps follow the same format as Neruda's collection in the sense that they are also short, brief, concise poems composed entirely of questions. But they are rooted in my own personal journey. They are rooted in my own personal experience of that of being a journalist, my personal experience being a poet, of being a human being. And these are my own quest to perhaps find meaning in the most unexpected of places. So here's one which I want to read out, which is called The Children of Palestine. "What happens to the souls of the children of Palestine? Do they go to heaven or fall into volcanoes? Do they rain on earth like acid rain? Do they escape like butterflies, never to look back on earth?" And this one's titled The Apples of Kashmir, which I wrote when I went to visit Kashmir in search of some story. But I couldn't do any journalistic story. All I could come up was with this poetry. "Why suddenly have the apples of Kashmir turned sour? Do the roots carry salt up to the apple flowers? Has the earth wept salty tears, or the people? Is there anything sadder in the world than sour apples hanging on an apple tree?" And this one started with the coup. "Did the trees and the fishes and other animals also vote for the government? Are they planning a coup soon? These historically tormented and tortured race of other living things?" And this one is titled Soul Food. It showcases my immense love for food. And it says, Do eggs know they have little suns trapped in them? Do watermelons know that they conceal little hillocks covered with pink snow? Do lychees know sweet melting glaciers flow through them? How does the artichoke contain the tenderness of its own heart? How much pain does the stone heart of the mango conceal? Does the coconut know? A deep, placid lake resides within it. And this one's called the Dead Sea. Who killed the Dead Sea? Or did it die of melancholy? Its immense saltiness, proof of its copious tears? Can someone drown in its own pool of tears? And this one's called Science. Can we build a calculator which knows all about numbers? So when we put 10 divided by 5, it sometimes shows 1 gets 8 and the rest 4 get a half each. So when we put 10 multiplied by 5, it sometimes shows 500 depending on the weather and other such things. And this one, the last one, which is titled The New General. And it asks, who is the new general of the dwindling army of pens and pencils and paints and brushes? And who gives them medals after their victories now? And who carries their dead bodies away from battlefields? Which borders do they protect nowadays? So there are many such questions, and as Neruda would say, you wouldn't want to answer them, but the questions will never die. Thank you so much.